Good morning, Namaskar, Sasriyakal, and Adab to all of you. So once again, we are all together here. You are all together here. And every day, we assemble here at the school. How many times do we really give it a thought? How much time do we spend together? How much time you people spend together with one another in a week's time? I believe every day we are spending 7 hours together. And we have almost 230 working days in a year. So if 7 hours in a day, how much time in a year? How much time in a year? It is more than 1,600 hours in a year. More than 1,600 hours in a year we are spending together. How much time?
1,600 hours. 1,000.
More than 1,600 hours we are spending together. But let us suppose we spend 5 years together. 5 years together. That means more than 8,000 hours together. With this much of time we are spending together. Yes, we are learning from our teachers. But equally, we are learning from one another. All of you are learning from one another. And it's very important that we should become very good example for one another so that we have wonderful environment in our institution where we are to spend more than 8,000 hours of our life. I mean, precious time we are to spend here, and here we are to groom ourselves for the life that we have ahead of ourselves. And life will definitely be beautiful if all of us present ourselves as extremely beautiful human beings in front of one another. This will definitely happen. This will surely happen if we have one thought in our mind, Supriya. One thought. Thought is, I am to become a source of inspiration for my classmate, for my schoolmate. A source of inspiration, strong source of inspiration. So what do we do in the class? In the class we focus. So with my focus, I am to inspire. With my focus, I am to inspire. There in the class, we talk to our teacher. So the language which I use, with my language, I am to inspire. In our school, we walk. In our classroom, we sit. The way I sit, the way I walk, the way I carry myself with my body language, I am to inspire. Let us suppose we are sitting in the class and legs are widespread. We are slouching in the class, or we are moving in the corridor in a very casual manner. Legs are broad, arms are broad, shoulders are tired. Is it a body language that inspires? Tell me, is it a body language that inspires? So with my body language, I am to inspire. It can be possible or it is very difficult? It can be possible, no? Is it possible or it is something very difficult? It is possible. So with my focus, I am to inspire. With my language, I am to inspire. With my words, I am to inspire. With my thoughts, I am to inspire. And with my body language, I am to inspire. Now, you come to the school and the teacher says, oh, what kind of shirt are you wearing? Look at your tie. Look at your trousers. It's dirty. It is shabby. It has got so many spots and stains. Daag dhabbe lage hue hain. So with this kind of uniform, do we really show respect for our uniform? Uniform is our identity. Uniform hamari pehchan. Is it or it is not? Is it our identity or it is not our identity? Uniform. So is it really important to have respect for uniform or it is not important? You mean? Is it important to have respect for uniform or it is not important? It is very important. Okay? So, with our respect for our uniform, we inspire. The way we present ourselves here at the school, we inspire. So, presentation is strong, haircut is proper, uniform is proper, then we inspire. What is difficult in this? Anything difficult? Anything difficult? It is something very simple. It is something very straight. And this is what we can all do. And this is what we will always do. So if we do all this, so we will inspire. The school. School is a place where we are to spend more than 8,000 hours. And all the teachers, when they come to school, they come with very strong preparation. Do they come or they don't? Do they come with strong preparation or they don't come with strong preparation? Without strong preparation, nobody can stand in a class for a minute. Your teachers stand in a class for more than 5 hours every day. And that is possible with strong preparation only. Now, if suppose this much of strong preparation is there by the teachers, and students are not regular, so can they inspire? Can they inspire? No. Okay? Inspire. So what is the decision of the students? We are to inspire with our regularity or we are to miss the school? We are to inspire with our regularity. Okay? So I will inspire with my regularity. Good. Wonderful. Wonderful. Now, you see, we have to improve. The other day, we were talking about Surabhi Gautam. What she was and what she became. Born in a village where there was no electricity. Studied with kerosene lamp. Okay, and yet she became a collector. Born in a very ordinary family. Parents were not well off at all. Born in a joint family where it was not easy to focus, where it was not easy to study. Yet she worked extremely hard. Is it good work culture or it is bad work culture? It is good work culture. She never felt tired. So if suppose with work we feel tired, so is it good work culture? If we are working and we get tired very soon, is it good work culture? If we work and we feel inspired, is it good work culture? So it is with our work culture that we have to inspire one another. Thake hare idhar udhar dekhkar, kya hum kisi ko inspire kar payenge? So dear students, what is our decision? I am to inspire all my classmates, all my schoolmates with my strong work culture. With my? What kind of work culture? Strong work culture. Okay? Next is, whatever Surabhi Gautam could become, that she could become with her knowledge. She became nuclear scientist, she became a railway officer, and then she became a collector. This all she could become with her knowledge, with her hard work. So with our knowledge we are to inspire. With our knowledge we are to inspire. So we will all strive very hard for knowledge. How many of you have decided that you will work extremely hard for knowledge? You will all love knowledge. You will all work for knowledge. You will all dedicate yourself to knowledge. Strong devotion towards knowledge will be there. Yes or no?
Yes.
Strong yes or weak yes?
Yes, sir.
Strong yes or weak yes?
Yes,
sir. Strong yes. Very good. Very good. Now say, yes, I inspire.
Yes, I inspire.
Yes, I inspire.
Yes, I inspire.
I inspire. With my words.
With my words.
I inspire.
I inspire.
With my thoughts.
With my thoughts.
I inspire.
I inspire.
With my deeds.
With my deeds.
I don't.
Ever mislead.
I focus.
I focus.
I learn.
I learn.
I write.
I read.
I read.
I do all.
That I need.
That
I do all
that I need.
Knowledge
I require.
Knowledge
I require.
For that
I perspire.
For that
I perspire.
I speak
with care.
I speak
with care.
Every word
is so fair.
Kya arth hua iska?
I speak
with care.
Every word
is so fair.
Kya matlab hua?
I speak with care.
कि हम सोच समझ के बोलते हैं और हर शब्द जो मुंह से निकालते हैं सुंदर शब्द निकालते हैं, कोई खराब घटिया शब्द हम अपने मुंह से नहीं निकालते हैं. ओके, ऑलराइट.
सिंसियरली आई से,
एल्डर्स आई ओबे.
क्या कहा जी हमने?
एल्डर्स आई ओबे.
जो हमारे बड़े हैं, हमारे अध्यापक हैं, हमारे माता पिता हैं, दादा दादी हैं, उनका हम कहना मानते हैं कि नहीं मानते?
मानते हैं.
हम झूठ बोल रहे हैं कि सच बोल रहे हैं?
सच बोल रहे हैं. ऑलराइट, गुड.
फॉर मी माय ड्यूटी
इज
अ थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी.
फॉर मी
माय ड्यूटी
इज अ थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी.
क्या कहा जी हमने?
फॉर मी माई ड्यूटी इज अ थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी.
क्या मतलब होगा?
यस निहारिका,
फॉर मी माई ड्यूटी इज अ थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी.
एनीवन?
फॉर मी माई ड्यूटी इज अ थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी.
यस नैन्सी गॉड,
for me my duty is a thing of beauty.
Could you understand?
No. भाई आपका जो कर्तव्य है वो आपके लिए सुंदर है या आपके लिए वो बदसूरत है?
सुंदर है ना.
तो this is what it means.
For me my duty is a thing of beauty.
Okay.
और
this beauty I admire.
This beauty I admire.
Yes, I inspire.
Yes, I inspire.
Yes, I
inspire.
सभी एक दूसरे के साथी हैं. किस प्रकार के साथी हैं? अच्छा साथी, बुरा साथी? अच्छा साथी. क्यों भावार? अच्छा साथी
जी.
तो ये जरा ये भी पीछे बोले, मैं एक अच्छा साथी हूं.
सबका साथ निभाता हूँ.
अपने ध्यान और ज्ञान से
प्रेरित करता जाता हूँ.
यही मेरा काम है.
अपना फर्ज निभाता हूँ.
लक्ष्य मेरे सामने है.
आगे कदम बढ़ाता हूँ.
लक्ष्य मेरे सामने है.
आगे कदम बढ़ाता हूं.
हर साथी को साथ लेकर
आगे मुझको बढ़ना है.
अब क्या बोले?
हर साथी को साथ लेकर
आगे मुझको बढ़ना है.
अच्छा बोल बोलना है.
खूब मुझको पढ़ना है.
किताब भी मेरी साथी है.
काम सदा ये आती है.
किताब भी मेरी साथी है.
काम सदा ये आती है.
भूल से भी मैं कभी
साथी को ना भटकाऊंगा.
राह जो मंजिल की ना हो,
राह ना ऐसी दिखाऊंगा.
क्या कहा जी हमने?
क्या कहा हमने?
साथी को भटकाऊंगा कि नहीं भटकाऊंगा? नहीं भटकाऊंगा। और कौन सी राह नहीं दिखाऊंगा? जो मंजिल की राह नहीं होगी वो कभी अपने साथी को दिखाएंगे? गुड गुड। दो रब जी ये वरदान, सही दोस्ती का दो दान, सही दोस्ती का दो दान। ओके, सो सिर्फ मिलना जुलना, सिर्फ गप्पे मारना, सिर्फ घूमना फिरना, यही दोस्ती नहीं है। अपने लक्ष्य का ध्यान रखना, लक्ष्य का रास्ता एक दूसरे को दिखाना, उसके लिए एक दूसरे को तैयार करने में एक दूसरे की मदद करना, अपना उदाहरण एक दूसरे के सामने रखना, ये असली दोस्ती है। ये सबको याद रहेगी? चलें, बोलते जाएं और चलते जाएं, मैं एक अच्छा साथी हूं, मैं एक अच्छा साथी हूं, सबका साथ निभाता हूं, अपने ध्यान और ज्ञान से प्रेरित करता जाता हूं, ये यही मेरा काम है, अपना फर्ज निभाता हूं, लक्ष्य मेरे सामने है, लक्ष्य मेरे सामने है, आगे कदम बढ़ाता हूं,
कदम बढ़ाता हूं, आगे कदम बढ़ाता हूँ।
सामने क्या?
जल्दी परिणाम,
लक्ष्य।
लक्ष्य मेरे सामने है, आगे कदम बढ़ाता हूँ, आगे कदम बढ़ाता हूँ। गुड, गॉड ब्लेस यू, कीप ऑन क्लैपिंग।